Welcome to MVC ASP.NET questions and answers video series. In this whole video series, we'll see that how we can create ASP.NET applications using MVC framework or the MVC template. So let's start with a very basic and the first lab or the first question of this video series. How do we create a simple hello world using ASP.NET MVC template? So before we start the labs, let's look into the prerequisite what we need in order to create the MVC project. The first thing, if you have Visual Studio 2010, then you don't need to worry about anything because it's either Express Edition, Ultimate Edition, or Enterprise Edition. The ASP.NET MVC template comes free, with the Visual Studio 2010. But in case you are having Visual Studio 2008, then the first thing is that you should have Service Pack 1. And the second thing is you need to go to www.asp.net/mvc and you need to download the MVC 2 template from this site. So if you're having Visual Studio 2010, no worries, but in case you are having Visual Studio 2008, then you need to go to the www.asp.net/mvc and download the template, so that you can create MVC projects for ASP.NET. So the first thing, let's go to Microsoft Visual Studio 2010. Let's open Visual Studio 2010. So let's click on File, New Project, and so let's select Web. And in Web, you can see that there are a couple of MVC templates over here, like MVC 2 web application and MVC 2 empty web application. So let's select ASP.NET MVC 2 web application and let's give a nice name here. My first hello world. And let's click OK. Now, once you click OK, you can see that the template has created a certain project structure for us, where you can see various folders like controllers, models, views, etc. So in other words, the MVC template has created a roadmap for us, and by using this roadmap or by using this structure, we can create the model view controller projects very easily. So for example, if you want to add a controller, you can just say right click, add new controller, very easy. If you want to add a view, then right click, add a view. And if you want to add a model, that is nothing but your .NET classes, then you can say add new item and you can select the class. Okay, so in other words, it has created a structure for us, and by using this structure we can create our MVC project very easily. So let's start by adding a new controller here. So let me go and add a new controller and let's give a name to this hello world controller, add. So you can see that basically it has created a simple hello world controller class here. And this hello world controller class has an index action. So in other words, if anybody calls the hello world action from the browser, it will first go and call this index function, and this index function will return a view, and this view will be translated to action result object, and that action result object can be then displayed on the browser. So what we'll do is, let's go ahead and add a view to this action result. So let me right click on this action result and say add view, and let's keep the name as it is. And let's click on add. So you can see that basically it has created an index.aspx page here, and this index.aspx page will be invoked when anybody calls the hello world action. So let's go to the index.aspx page and let's say that, let's put something over here. This is our first MVC application. Okay, and let's do control F5. Now, once your application starts running, you will get an error like this, which you see on the browser. And this error is but obvious, why? Because you have yet not invoked any kind of action. If you remember right, our action was hello world. If you remember, we have created a controller called as hello world. And this hello world will invoke the page that is index.aspx. So let's go ahead on the URL and type here hello world. Now the time you type hello world, you can see that basically our index.aspx page is displayed. So in other words, the first hit comes to this controller, that is hello world controller, and from there he basically goes and invokes the view and displays the view on the page. So this was a very basic application. Now what we'll do is, in this series, in the further coming videos, we'll look into that how we can pass data from controller to the view. So in other words, like, let's say that in a controller you have some data which you have modified and you would like to display the data on the view. So I hope that you have enjoyed this video. In the coming up video, we'll look into how we can pass persistent data like view state or session variables on the view page.